Hello, my name is Kerry Pace. I'm the founder of Diverse Learners. I'm a specialist dyslexia tutor. I specialise in supporting nurses and healthcare students in HE and staff in the workplace who have disabilities, particularly dyslexia and dyspraxia. So today we're going to look at assistive technology. Assistive technology is a common reasonable adjustment both in academia and in healthcare settings. It's very standard and recommended in most assessment of needs documents for disabled students allowances, which your students will be funded by, and through access to work. So none of these should be really challenged in any way for placement support. It's a very reasonable adjustment and it's a precedent in the NHS in the fact that lots of people are using it across the NHS. Right, so here we go. We have grouped them together here into overview for you. So here we have text-to-speech software. So this is software that takes a text and makes it speak out loud to you. So you might have heard that on Google Maps, for example, or a sat-nav where it says turn left. It's that kind of idea. It's very useful for people who have dyslexia and dyspraxia or visual impairment. Also very good for people with English as a second language who often have a higher listening rate of accuracy than a reading rate of accuracy. So we have Claro, Read Write Gold, JAWS, which also magnifies the text as well as reads it out for those people who are visually impaired or blind, and a screen ruler, which colours a certain amount of text so it makes it much easier for you to read or to track across and not make any errors. Then we have some mind mapping software, the most commonly identified as useful for students in their packages for DSA is Inspiration here and MindView there. We've got some examples of that coming up. Note-taking software, really versatile. It's more than just putting it on a dictaphone. This does extra tasks for you and extra tools for you on here. So there's Audio Note Taker here, which is by Sonocent, and Note Talker here. We're going to talk about those a bit later as well. Then we have Dragon, which is speech-to-text software or voice recognition software, or sometimes dictation software it might be called. So you speak and it talks. So if anybody's ever used Siri, for example, to search the internet sometime, or phone somebody and say, oh, phone, I don't know, Joe Blogs, it will often come up as phone Joe Blogs before it asks you and before it does it. So it's originally identified for people with disabilities, but we're using it very much mainstream now, and this is the idea I want you to get hold of today, is that this software is actually really useful for everybody. Now we have Mendical, which is a medical spell checker. I'm bringing this up because a lot of medical spell checkers are USA based, which makes it quite difficult in terms of spelling for S's and Z's and different spellings from USA to UK spellings. Also, it has generic drug names, which are UK based, and brand names, which of course are different in the US. It was created by two medical students, one who had dyslexia, one is English as a second language. They got fed up with the red wiggly lines on Word for things that were spelt wrongly, but actually were spelt correctly. They were just medical terms. So they created their own dictionary, and you can have that running in the background and it will increase accuracy for everybody and save so much time, because only you, the red wiggly lines will come up when it's spelt incorrectly. So what we're going to do now is have a quick look at a mind mapping software, which this one is called Inspiration. I created this with a student in order for them to become have a template for learning their drugs for their drug calculation exam. So we put things under indications, contraindications, cautions, side effects and dose, but you could put any drug in the middle there. And it was a real visual way for them to learn the information. They got very lost in pages and pages of information on each drug, and this is the way that they presented it. So that was done very simply on mind mapping software. This is also mind mapping software called Inspiration. It's a really useful Inspiration because it gives you a template, so does MindView as well. So I did a template here and filled it in. So we had paper versus software in terms of assistive technology software. And here we have the differences and the similarities in the middle. You can import pictures, as you can see. You can dash your arrows. You can make them fat, put them different colours, change your background colour. So it's very, very flexible. Now, the nicest thing of all is there's this outline button out here, which will change it and convert it into a bullet point list. So it takes all the information on screen and transfers it into a bullet point list, which you then can transfer onto Word. So again, if different people like working in different ways, so I love mind mapping, my husband hates it. So I convert my mind map into an outline linear list, bullet point list if you like, and send it to him. And we also have this as a presentation. So I plan all my documents, and a lot of my students plan their presentations for their assignments in my mapping software, click the button and it automatically changes it to a PowerPoint presentation without any jiggery-pokery at all. So here we go, outlines, that's what it looks like on outline. You can see that we've added notes and audio notes down here, so it's very flexible. And here we have a presentation. So we press the presentation button, it converts it into a PowerPoint straight away. So here you could see it as a linear list, and here you can see all the options you've got as parts of your mind map. So a very useful, interactive, multi-sensory way of producing your PowerPoints with mind maps and with linear lists to meet lots of people's needs, so that's more inclusive, but also much less planning because you're only planning once and then converting. So this is software that reads text to you. Here we have it on a device, just for an example, where it's highlighting each word, but you don't have to have it like that. You could have it with no highlighting, different colours highlighting, sentences, paragraphs, for example. You can also, really excitingly, take papers or articles or agendas or meeting notes and convert them into MP3 or MP4. So it means you can actually listen to them in the car, or if you're travelling, or if you just learn better that way, you can actually listen to all the information being read to you. So it's a really nice interactive way of working, and also meets lots of people's different needs. This is the button you might have seen on PubMed or CINAHL, where papers can be read to you as well. But have a look for that. It's in all sorts of places. You won't necessarily look for it, see it if you're not looking for it. Claro is software that is specializes in making the voices really good. So they've got female and male voices, as most software has that is that speaks to you. However, they've gone for accents as well. So they've got English with a Scottish accent, English with a Welsh accent, English with an Irish accent, English with an Australian accent, Indian accent, all sorts of things. Which, when you think about the nationalities in the NHS, there should be an accent that suits everybody. I particularly like the Scottish one because I was brought up in Scotland, so it makes it a lot more effective for me. Read Write Gold also has male and female voices, but has specialised in the tools that go alongside, so a dictionary with definitions, a thesaurus with alternatives, so you make sure you choose the right word. Also, it has a toolbar with study tools that can highlight, for example. So same software, but different extras. Then we have inbuilt software. So not a lot of people know that actually on your computer, if you do the Windows key, which is this key, Control plus N, it will read anything to you that's on the screen. And it's free. Here is Google Live Transcribe on Android phones. Great for deaf people. If you're working with deaf people, one, you can talk into it and it'll then show the deaf person what you're saying. So as with 8.3 million deaf people in the country, and 65,000 BSL users, or British Sign Language users, it's very useful to communicate in this way. Or if you've got a person who can speak to you with a good voice who is deaf but can't hear, they could speak to you and then you could use Google Live Transcribe to talk into it and then show them what you've said. A really versatile tool. So here we have Sonnison Audio Note Taker. A really handy piece of kit with lots of extras in it. So originally, you might have seen a dictate, if you've used a dictaphone, for example, you've seen the sound in blocks like this coming out, so the gaps are where people would take breaths. But what this allows you to do is color code that audio. Also delete the audio that you don't want. And so a 2-hour meeting, if you're just looking for your agenda points, for example, could be really cut down into maybe 10 minutes of useful stuff. Of course, meetings are very useful, but the ones that are relevant to you. And here we have the image. So this could be agenda point one or meeting page one. And then you put the text or the notes in between the two, so to link the two. However, this could be lecture slide one. This could be the audio for lecture slide one. And in the middle could be your personal notes for lecture slide one. You then hit return and slide two will come up with the audio for slide two, and any interesting points or information that you need to look up or double check or a question you need to ask can be recorded in here. And it's a very versatile, interactive, multi-sensory way of working and really useful for lots and lots of people. So you already have a piece of assistive technology on your phone or device. You may not know it, but again, it's looking for this symbol here. I call it like a Rat Pack or a Michael Bublé kind of microphone. And it's deep speech to text software. Now, some of you might have used it through Bluetooth to send a text home while you're driving, for example. Some of you might have picked pressed on it to ask Siri a question. So you're saying, Siri, can you find me the nearest restaurant, or can you phone Phoebe, for example? And it will bring what you've asked it up in text, and then you would click yes. So it might be that you've used it already, and those pieces of software are originally developed for people with disabilities, but as you can see, writing text and using Siri has become very much mainstream. So this software is really useful for lots and lots of different people for lots of different reasons. It's not solely for people who have disabilities. So here's an activity. Try on your phone or your tablet to write a text message using your voice, using this symbol here. It's usually next to your space bar. If it's not next to your space bar, you can go into your accessibility menu first and find that either voice recognition or dictation. Click that and it will then make sure that that is available on your keyboard, on your phone or your device. So here we have software where you speak and it talks again. So, you know, I always do this. It speaks and it writes for you. So this is why I always call it you speak, it types, because it's just much easier, because I always get the speech to text around the wrong way. Very dyspraxic thing to do. Okay, so here we have Dragon, which is free, which is fantastic, as an app or on your phone as a tablet. And also, which is these other three are also, these other two over here are also free. So this dictation or speech recognition, you might call it, is writing as you speak. On Microsoft, it's built in on your Windows 365 or Windows 10. So you click on the Windows logo key, you hit Control and S, and it will start reading what's on the, a little toolbar will come up. You click on it and then you start speaking and it will start typing. Voice dictation in Google Docs is an excellent tool, really accurate. I've been really impressed with it. You find it under Tools, and it's called Voice Typing. You then click to speak what you want to, say full stop at the end, click to stop it, and then it will produce it for you. It's really accurate, and it's free and really flexible, so I really recommend that. Because Dragon for a PC, you have to pay for. It does have the added benefits of reading your documents and getting to know what your specialist language is and the way you talk is, so that's a benefit, but you do have to pay for it. Also, there's a Dragon Medical, additional paid in-app purchases, so you can add vocabulary from for radiography, for example, or A&E, and again, it will have some additional voices for you. Right, so there we go. So mobile devices and assistive technology apps. The reason I brought this up is we're actually going to discuss this in detail in another video, but I just wanted to just very quickly run through that all of this software is available as apps on your device. So if you want a seamless approach, you might have it on your PC at home, but your student will really benefit, or your member of staff will really benefit from having it on their phone as well. So whatever they do on their phone, they can then upload to their PC, and when they're uploading their PC to their phone. So MindView, for example, and a couple of the others have started doing an online version, so that you don't get a license for your PC, you actually use it in the cloud. So therefore you can use it on any desktop, any device, if you buy that package. So I'd really think about carefully what package you're buying for the person you're supporting. So reading is here, there's all the Read, Write, Gold and Claro. Planning and processing is your mind mapping software. This is iThoughts, which is free. Drug calculations, here's Dragon, here's recording meetings with Note Talker and Audio Sonocent. And I'll go through the others on a different video in more depth. So the reason I brought this up is because Every Nurse is an E-Nurse is a Royal College of Nursing campaign at the moment, and NHS are hoping to go digital much more efficiently. They've got NHS apps developing, and also they're hoping to go paperless in 2020. So technology is on its way. So we need to start embracing it and accepting it. And then this one here is to remind you not only that a mobile phone or device is really useful to communicate with people with English as a second language, because there's a translate button on it, or people who are deaf, but also by more and more now we're seeing hearing aids that if you switch them to the T setting, it actually creates a virtual loop. So in times past, you had to have a fixed loop in a specific room or a portable loop, but it will then amplify everything in that loop. So everything will become noisy, the background noise, the chairs scraping, for example. But this allows you just to make a very small loop, say sitting at a restaurant or a table or a consultation, just between the two people, which means people who use hearing aids, and there's 8.3 million of them, as I said before, will be able to get a lot more out of the consultation or the conversation that you're having. So allowing devices makes a big difference, not only for the patients, but for you yourselves. We'll discuss this in more detail, as I said, and there's some other videos that you might want to look at in placement and on policy, so have a look at those. In the meantime, my name is Kerry Pace. I'm the founder of Diverse Learners. You can contact me on kerry@diverse-learners.co.uk. And this has been produced in collaboration with the University of Plymouth.